streets of the Ohio, Allegheny, and Monongahela Rivers at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City, and a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with the Carolina Panthers. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis with you, and now we sit, CD, at week three of the preseason, and this is the one that the coaches probably think is pretty valuable, right?
Certainly. This is the dress rehearsal. This is the one where your starters are going to play. You might even game plan a little bit more than you do with a normal preseason game, and then you've got to decide, do you bring them back after halftime and get them going again in the third quarter so they're ready to go when the regular season begins? I'm eager to see how these coaches will handle that.
So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And a glance here at their quarterback standing 6'3".
And what I'm looking for from him today, the things every quarterback is looking to do. Lead his team to a victory. Doesn't matter whether he's throwing it, running it, handing it off, however he has to do it, as well as exhibiting some leadership, that's what he's trying to accomplish. Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy set the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage here, forced the ball free, and it's second down. And again, this time to the tailback. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. Now, after the running play, we got a man down on the field. Definitely the last thing you want to see here on preseason game. We'll be right back. He finds his man complete. That's Hoover. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout. An injured player operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10, right at the 40. They'll look to throw here. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Not much there, only a yard.
And let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on, you're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
Now a throw here to his running back, and they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers 21. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back. Now a handoff as they run left side. Broken tackle. All the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. The impressive opening drive continues, and just space being created by those guys up front.
We're seeing this the same way, aren't we? We are seeing an offensive line as this game gets started. Starts to unfold, they are dominating the line of scrimmage.
He pushes forward, but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one.
It's definitely hard to find space near the goal line. You always want to have a guy in the game running it who can create his own.
They'll try to run this one in. And he'll take this in the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Panthers take it right down and score. The score 7-0. A 10-play drive that time, and it ends with a 1-yard touchdown run. This taken in at the goal line. He's going to be stopped here with a penalty marker on the field. I'm not Season now in week three. Defensive coordinator wise, what's he looking at?
Or get through contact or trash,
makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. And now here's a carry heading left. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage, and now 3rd and 11 coming up. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll go down to the ground at the 39, and obviously that's well short of the first. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down.
Brandon, a good idea there on 3rd down. Run a little clear out and hope you get your receiver the ball coming across the formation.
So holding there on the return, and that'll back him up to start the next drive.
Yeah, that's a pretty easy call right there, partner. I think when the officials look in their manual and see the expression, jersey getting pulled,
and he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6.
With the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back there and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for 3rd down. Back to throw. Run. He finds his man. Complete. It's Flowers. The Steelers' 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
That's a pretty good throw on the corner out there. 3rd down, and they pick up the 1st.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
Yeah, they should be aware, but it's so hard to
test. It's not easy.
Because the Browns saw that right really well. They picked the ball up. Show their numbers to the quarterback and complete the play.
He'll try again with the arm here on 2nd down. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. And that's gonna wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag. Let's check it by the referee. So a costly penalty yardage wise is that'll move the football down to the spot of the foul.
And what the officials are looking for in these situations, whether you're playing the man or the ball. And if you're playing the man, you get a lot less leeway in terms of what's going to happen at the end of the play. But if you're looking for the football, it's less likely to draw the flag.
Calling a gain of 4 on 1st, and that'll make it 2nd down. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. To throw on 2nd down. Run. Tackles made at the Panthers 16.
Like the play design there, they occupied the defense downfield. Everyone trying to account for someone, but unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield, and he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4. And the snap will come inside the 5 of the 4.
Yeah, once more, a strong running, excellent blocking of the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive room right here.
Looking to throw. Run. Flush to his right. And he's going to take it in for a steal. Touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Steelers have taken the lead. One away. This one away. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. Yeah, the Steeler offense, they're set up nicely as they take over. Pittsburgh offense making their way back out. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Second and two. That's a short one here, complete to his tight end.
Should be an easy outlet. All those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A little hot route, so to speak.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move it on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball back because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
So here's a first and 10 now, down inside the 20. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And just a couple yards there, down to the 17.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you play strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. It's a gain of six, moves him to a manageable third and two situation.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it.
Trail by 10, 17-7 as they come up on a first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Second down at 7. And again, this time to the tailback. Shedding the tailback, gives him some room. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 62 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half.
Partner, in our years together, we've never really run into a player that's admitted a doubt or a lack of confidence, right? But right now, I'm just wondering about that interior line because on defense, they're starting to get manhandled at the point.
Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting it back on the sand.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. And he'll work this one up to about the 38.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that anytime he hit the ball to him.
The Panthers on third down. They've had 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 17. They'll look to throw. And he's got his big tight end here. And to the 49-yard line, but no further. And obviously, he is well short of the first. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. There's the Panthers punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Taken in at the 11. Good blocking there, nearly sprung him as it is. There goes a 19-yard return. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
He doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back. And that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle. Going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
They'll get only three there, so it leaves them with a third and seven ahead. And Steelers on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and seven. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action.
None of that.
Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan, coach, were both larger than life. Stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
On fourth down, here's Presley Harvin on to punt. And a good result there as that'll get out of bounds and pin him back at their 10-yard line. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin him back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong? You know, back and forth like that, that definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. They'll look to throw now on first down. And it takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. First down now, but that clock rolling. To play here in half number one. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. He'll look to throw. And he'll find his man on the outside. And he goes out wide around the 39.
Unnecessary roughness. Defense.
Too much extracurricular there.
When you have a game with a lot of contact, tensions are going to run pretty high. You're going to be emotional, but you have to harness it somehow. And he didn't on that play.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And the final man in the end route complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Quick hitter here. It's complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. And the 10-yard back knocks it to the goal post. And they're back within a touchdown at 17-10. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So we reach halftime here in the Steel City with the Steelers on time. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. Week 3 of the preseason is here. Everyone wrapping up their exhibition schedule. No games for the league on Labor Day weekend. And then it all begins. The 17-game regular season gets underway on the Thursday after Labor Day with the NFL kickoff game. In our game, expect to see the starters for at least one more drive. Something to look forward to as we get you back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach. Yeah, adjustments likely going to be a good one when it starts. It's been a tight contest so far. From the 6. Ready to get going here in this third quarter. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. They'll start the third quarter here on the ground. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29. Here's second and 9. Just a yard on that last run.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. The legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will have first down. There he is. He's going down with the 40-pound.
I guess a lot of shoulders just dropped there. But what I mean by that is they finally able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. Back to throw now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 7 yards to pick up there. 3 yards remain for second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Now a leaping catch, he's got it. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
The coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. How do you get much more balance than this? Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination, look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of punch.
It's nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. A turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
A toss left side into the hands of his tight end. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
56, Mike, 56, right there, 56.
Come on! Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes this one down to the 15.
What were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you should have a few men in the box there.
Scrimmage the 15. It's first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the second and 8. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
From the gun, they'll try to run. Heavy tackle right on the 10, well short of the first down. 3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. And for the second time tonight, his field goal unit comes out here. For this third quarter, first time this preseason that they played into the second half.
And that's by design. Most of the time by this point of the preseason, you want them to go into the half, cool down, and then come back out and warm up to start the third quarter like you would a regular season game. That's exactly what they wanted to get done.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll drop the throw.
So far, it feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
And this one nearly intercepted. Boy, that would have been a great time for their first pick. But instead, it's third down. Throw.
In this case, unsuccessful.
That was a punt of 32 yards. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory.
Pittsburgh set to take over again on offense.
And last time they were able to churn some clock. They got the field goal, added onto their lead, but that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game. We probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive, and he's going to profess that he was happy to get points. And we know that's not true. Okay, after this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
And it'll be taken down, but not before he gets his football out shy of the 30 to the 29. They go play action here on first down. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
A second and 10 forthcoming here. Third quarter action in the Steel City of Pittsburgh, PA.
And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked out for a week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drove in.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. Hey, sidebar worth noting is that preseason cuts have changed. So week three that we're in right now, the preseason, what'd you say, the roster's going to stay at 90 instead of going down to 75 this year?
That's exactly right, Brandon, because in the past, just what you said, this game here, at the end of week three, or game three, you would cut the roster down to 75 and play game four just like that. In this case now, though, they'll be able to keep guys all the way through. So guys who would normally not have a chance to finish out the preseason, they'll get that chance now and get more opportunities to get on tape.
From the gun, he'll hand this off.
And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line.
85 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now a handoff as they run left side. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
And that's caught inside the 35. He is out of bounds inside the 35. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now it's the backup Mayfield. Second and 2.
Only needing 2 yards on second down.
They'll try the left side. McClendon. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. They'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. Another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 15-yard line.
Every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a one-score game. I can't imagine that in their huddle, that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back.
And we'll take it across for Panthers touchdown. A 15-yard touchdown run.
And the Panthers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
Extra point right down the middle. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Send out a kick. This one. This one is a fair catch, a single four and taken. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. That last touchdown has made this really tight. They're clinging now to this slim lead. Well, Jesus, second half, they only have a field goal. This offense needs to kick it into gear.
And right now, I'm looking directly at the field general, at the quarterback. This, to me, he's got to take over right now.
They're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play is.
Shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Again, he'll drop to throw. Eluding the pressure right. He's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete. First quarter, Charles, you really emphasized the importance of winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. They haven't forced a single turnover in this game.
And right now they're losing, so no turnovers might lead to no victory.
This pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Team on now as this one set away. And this one will be touchdown right at the 30-yard line. Possession of the football goes over to Carolina. And you sense the tide turning. They scored, then their defense forced the punt, and now a chance to ultimately take the lead here late. Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. Dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, to watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
A first down throw from Mayfield. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three. Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. Working out of the gun. Mayfield. Flushed out right. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. A gain of eight there on the play. And that'll make this a second down. And his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best. It keeps him out of the big plays. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Mayfield on third and two. And let's go. Touchdown, Panthers. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front. Now the try here for the point after. And that will make this a four-point game. A drive that time of six plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signal for and taken successfully. Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. But the bad news for them, they've seen that cushion they once had totally evaporate, and they're working from behind. The good news, they now have the opportunity to regain the lead right back. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a three-yard gain there.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Catch made by Slayton. They stop a probably three that time, and then bring up fourth down.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast, too. Converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. Nowhere to go. He lost the football. And the offense will recover, but it won't make much difference here. This will still be a turnover on downs. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. First down, Mayfield. Are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good. And that pushes the lead up to 11. And they got the ball in great field position. One play later, boom, end zone. This will be fielded inside the five. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Steelers offense gets ready to get back onto the field. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit. On first and 10, Hayes. And the coverage terrific there as it's knocked down and incomplete. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. Second and 10 for the 25. Territory now. It's first and 10 at the 38. Oh, he lost the football. And the Panthers have recovered.
You know, this is the season part where we talk about just how costly a mistake that was, but probably good for him to get it out of his system right now.
Just hope for him and the team. It's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, without a doubt. Plus, got to worry about making the team. Those types of errors don't help.
On first down, McClendon. Six-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Now whistles here, and it looks looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. Definitely the last thing you want to see here in a preseason game. We'll be right back. Keep it here on first and 10. But he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. On second down now. It's Haynes. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
Chuckle myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. If you got control of this thing, get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
Well, the spotlight hit him once already tonight as he got into the end zone. He was trying to make it a double spotlight, wasn't he?
But credit the defense, bottling him up, not letting him get in for the second score there. Charles, in this one, I think the storyline really, the fourth quarter, coming into it neck and neck, but they were able to separate, put their foot on the gas, and get the win.
And since you mentioned neck and neck, I'm going to stay with a little bit of a horse racing theme. It was that close, and then really went into the gallop and finished it strong.
One more horse racing theme.
Go.
I am glad you posted today.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say goodnight from Pittsburgh.